Hello students, today I am going to discuss Spearman's rank correlation coefficient. Let xi, yi, where I is equal to 1 to n, be the ranks of ith individual in two characteristics. This is a statement, student, you need to remember it. Characteristics A and B respectively. Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation between the ranks as xi's and yi's is called the rank correlation coefficient between A and B for the group of individuals. Now, students, the rank correlation coefficient looks like this. It is given by rank is equal to 1 minus 6 sigma di square by n into n square minus 1. You can say it as rho also. So here, after this, students, we are going for proof. Just see the proof, you will understand it more clearly. See here, students, see this one. I'm just increasing the screen size so that it is visible for you easily. The best way to understand this method and this proof is, remember it like this. First thing you need to do is remember, first you have to calculate x bar and y bar. Second thing is you have to calculate sigma x square and sigma y square. Then the last one you have to calculate di. Okay, like this, if you remember, you can answer it easily in the exam. Now, first thing, we are calculating x bar. X bar is 1 by n summation of xi. You have done in the intermediate, no, students? Summation of xi is 1, 2, 3, so on till n. We will substitute I is equal to 1 to n, no? So, x 1, 2, 3, it will go on till n. So, 1, 2, 3, so on till n, we denote it as n into n plus 1 by 2, right? And this 1 by n, we are just writing like that. Here, it is 1 by n. So, just cancel this n and this n. You will be left with n plus 1 by 2. It is written here. In the same way, you will calculate y bar also, students. It is 1 by n summation yi. Then just summation I is equal to 1 to n, no? That's why you are putting here 1, 2, 3, so on till n. So 1 by n you are writing here, n into n plus 1 by 2 you are writing it here. Just cancel this n and this n. You will be left with what, students? You will be left with n plus 1 by 2. Then, students, you can you see this? It is this n plus 1 by 2 is same for x bar also and y bar also. So, you are writing x bar is equal to y bar is equal to n plus 1 by 2. Just remember this, students, x bar is equal to y bar. In further discussion, we are going to discuss about this. Then, students, this one also, n plus 1 by 2 also. Then, students, it is x summation sigma x square. Sigma x square, the formula is, actually we will write it like this, no, 1 by n summation of xi minus x bar whole square, right? Summation of xi minus, I'm just writing it, minus x bar whole square, right? Yes, the sigma x square is nothing but xi minus x bar whole square. We will put this summation and the square inside. It will become 1 by n summation xi square minus x bar square. Then students, what will happen? It will be 1 by n. This summation xi square, as we have done for 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on till n, it was n into n plus 1 by 2. Again, if it is summation xi square, it is 1 square, 2 square, so on. 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, so on till n square. The formula for that is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. You have done this in inter, remember. So, here you can cancel this n and this n, you have n plus 1 by 2 into 2n plus 1 by 6. And what is x bar, students? This one, no, n plus 1 by 2, we are writing it here because x bar square is there, you are writing it square here. Then students, after that, just make this n plus 1 common, n plus 1 by 2 common. If you make it common, you will be left with this 2n plus 1 by 3 2s are 6, no? You are writing 3 over here. Then n plus 1 by 2, 1 you are writing here, 1 is outside the brackets. Then students, just do the LCM of this 3 and 2, it will be 3 2s are 6. Then just cross multiply this, you have minus here, cross multiply this. Here minus is there, no? Minus into plus, it will be minus here. Then 4n minus 3n and 2 minus 3, you will get n minus 1 by 6. What is 3? 6 2s are 12, right? Here you will write 12. You have n plus 1 and n minus 1. A plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. That's why you are writing n square minus 1 square, which is 1 only. You got the answer for sigma x square. It will be same for sigma y square. So the answer for sigma x square and sigma y square is n square minus 1 by 12. Again, students, in general, xi is not equal to yi. We got x bar is equal to y bar. We got sigma x square is equal to sigma y square. But xi will not be equal. And students, let di is equal to xi minus yi. So here, students, just understand this. As I told you before, x bar is equal to y bar, we have discussed just now. If I write here minus of x bar and minus of x bar and plus of x bar, if we write minus and plus for x bar here, now what I am doing, students, instead of writing x bar here, I am just removing this x bar and making it y bar. It is same, no? X bar and y bar is same, no? For that reason, what I am doing, instead of writing x bar, I am writing y bar over here. So here you can write this x bar xi and this xi minus of this x bar over here, this one here, and minus, you will write this minus here. If you put bracket, this plus will become minus. If you remove the bracket, this plus will be plus only. Then this yi minus y bar you will write here. After that, students, one thing is you have to put summation on both sides. Okay, summation on both sides, this equal to and this equal, that equal to. Then another thing is you have to put square on both sides. Then the third thing is you have to put 1 by n on both sides. If you put these three things, you will be getting this one. 1 by n, this side and that side. Now see, students, this have become a minus b whole square form, right? So it is a square, 1 by n you have put on both sides, no? Here also and there also. Sigma also you have put on both sides, summation and square. Then a square plus b square minus 2ab you are writing here. See here, it is written. Now students, just now I told you sigma x square, here I have shown you the formula, no? This formula is for sigma x square, right? So you are writing in place of 1 by n summation of xi minus x bar square, you are writing sigma x square. Then again sigma y square for this one, and 2 into covariance of x y for this part. Okay, 1 by n summation of xi minus x bar, yi minus y bar is nothing but covariance of xi x comma y. Now here you can put 1 by n, same you are writing it here. You can write summation of x square and summation of y square. Now students, you can write rho covariance of x comma y is nothing but rho of x sigma x and sigma y. See here students, as we have sigma x square and sigma y square, we got same, no? Sigma x square answer and sigma y square answer, we got same. So that means sigma x is also equal to sigma y. So in place of writing sigma y, we are writing sigma x here. So sigma x into sigma x is nothing but sigma x square, right? Rho 2 sigma x square, you got then 2 rho sigma x square, you can write sigma x square plus sigma x square is 2 sigma x square here. Then students, just make this 1 minus rho common, 1 minus rho into 2 sigma x square here. Then after that, what is sigma x? The answer for sigma x, just now we have evaluated, we got 2 n square minus 1 by 12, which we can cancel this 2 and 12 here, you will get 6. This 6 we can cross multiply it to here, it will be 6 sigma di square, and we can get this n square minus 1 to the next year denominator, we will be left with this n into this n square minus 1. We got it as n into n square minus 1, and this 1 minus rho is already there here. We are just keeping it like that. Then students, after that, in the next line, you can get this rho to the left hand side, and this 6 sigma di square by n into n square minus 1 to the right hand side. It will be, this will become positive. Rho is equal to 1 minus 6 sigma di square by n into n square minus 1. That's what I wanted to tell you in this lecture. Please like, share and subscribe, students. This is an important topic, okay?